What is this make research symbol? Actually, so most of the researcher, they are not doing their research in a systematic manner. If you do the research in a systematic manner, you can complete the research in a short span, as well as you can publish paper in well-reputed journals. So that systematic approach only we are going to explain today. If you do the research in this manner, what we are going to explain today, definitely you can complete your research in a short span. So make research simple means don't think that we can complete the research over a night. It is not possible. So within the stipulated period, most of the researchers, they are saying that, so I crossed 5 years, 6 years, I am unable to complete the research. So for them, it is easy. Similarly, the beginners, those who are planning to do research. So this webinar will be a very useful webinar, how to do the research in a systematic manner as well as publish paper in a reputed journal. So before that, first you must understand what do you mean by research. So what is research means? Investigation of new. For example, now the world is suffering with corona. There is no medicine for corona. If you are able to find the medicine for corona, it is called investigation of new. That means the thing which is not available in the world, you are investigating that. A new product, it may be a new method, it may be a new algorithms. Which is not available in the world, that you are investigating means that's what called investigation of new. So for doing this, the people working in research laboratory like ISRO, DRDO, for them it is easy because they have well-established research lab. In that lab, it consists of a lot of testing equipment, latest software, measuring instruments, everything will be available. So it is not feasible for the people, those who are working in engineering colleges, that to do part-time research. It is not possible because these sort of research laboratory will not be there in most of the organization. So the investigation of new, so that will be feasible for somebody. So most of them it is not feasible. So they are going for next type of research. It is also a research. What is this research means? Implementation of new method, new algorithm, new technology for an existing and solved recent problems. So this is what most of the researchers are doing, this sort of research. So here, the problem is already solved. It is not a new problem. The previous one, it is a new problem. Nobody solved that problem. But in the second type of research, it is not a new problem. It is already solved problem. In the solved problem, so what we have to do means you have to implement new method or new algorithm or latest technology so that the parameters in the recent problem can be improved. For example, so far the efficiency attained is 80% in the solved problem. So far it is 80%. By using new method or new algorithm, if you are able to improve the efficiency to 85% or 90%, this is also a research. So this research only, most of the research scholars are, they are doing it. Next, identifying the area. This is the very, very important part before starting a research. So first one is, you can select the area based on your interest. For example, you are interested in image processing, you are interested in power system or power electronics, control system, machines, whatever it may be, the interested area you can select. But the main problem is, if you are selecting your interested area, you must go through that, how much quantum of work carried out in that area. For example, you are interested in power electronics, that to power converter. If you go through the power converter, lot of works are carried out in the power converter means you have to contribute a lot, then only your work will be recognized. Instead of that, if you select the area where minimum number of works are carried out, so only few works or minimum number of works are carried out in the area, if you select that area, smaller work have lot of recognition. So it is the better if you select the area where minimum number of works are carried out. In that means your paper will be published very easily so that you can complete your research. In the two way you can select your area, your interest, that is one part. Second one is the area where minimum number of works are carried out. Next one is how to start the research. So most of the researchers, they don't know how to start the research. So you already, you selected your area. In your area, first you collect a literature in the recent journal publication. You select a paper. That too in the recent publication. the journal must be a reputed journal. Don't select not top rated journal. You select a top rated journal in your area, that too recent journal. In that, in your area, some paper will be published. You select that paper. For example, now you are starting the research. Now it is 2020. At least June month published paper is well and good. Otherwise, this year at least, right, in your area, you select a paper. So in that paper, you have to ask four questions. One is what, second one is how, next one is previous, last one is next. You have to ask these four questions. First one is what. So what problem they did in that paper. So that by reading the paper, you can able to find what problem they are taken. How it is solved. So what method they used. So what are the parameters they used. What is the outcome of the paper. That's what how. How it is implemented. How it is. So the paper will be solved. So that you have to ask next question. First one is what. What is the problem they are taken. Second one is how it is solved. Third one is previous. What are the works carried out in that area previously? So that is called literature review. I will explain that in the next slide. Next one is next. What is next? What are the area left in the your selected area? That's what next. That's called problem identification. That's also I explain in the next slide. So to start a research, you collect a recent journal paper of your area and ask these four questions, your work will be started. What is the problem? How it is solved? Previous and next. So what and how, by reading the paper itself you can identify, but the previous you have to do some literature review. Next, you have to formulate the problem statement for your research. So next one is that previous question, that's called literature review. What is literature review means? Study of previous work carried out for a particular problem. That's called a literature review. Study of previous works carried out for a particular problem. So in your case, in your area, right, in your selected paper, that's called your base paper, there what are the works previously carried out? So that you have to study first. Most of the researcher, they will not study literature review. They directly go and implement something. So that's why they are unable to complete with a stipulated period. Next, how to do the literature review? Collect the recent SCA journal of in your area. SCA journal means, you know, that elsewhere, Taylor and Francis, IET, IEEE, that type of journal in your area, and consider that as your base paper. Normally, any research, we need a base paper. So from the base paper only, you have to start your work. The base paper only, I told that in the previous slide, you have to ask four questions. So first, you have to select your base paper, that is in the recent area, that SCA journal paper. First, collect all the references given in the base paper. For example, you are collected a base paper that consists of 35 references or 30 references in that paper. First, you collect that 30 references. Don't take the printout initially. You collect the paper. So, while saving the paper in your system, you save by year. Right? So, by year, you have to save all the papers. So, 35 papers you are collected. Then these 35 paper, again reference will be there, right? 35 papers, they give a lot of references. Now you may ask, one paper it is 35 references means 35 paper, how much references it will come? Say above 1000 references. It is not like that, because most of the paper, the references are repeatedly referred references. So don't afraid of that. So if you collect 35 references, in 30 references given in 35 references, hardly you will get your 50 or 60 new papers. All the other papers are repeatedly referred papers. Like this, you have to collect the papers till the starting point of your research. So first you collect the paper and save in a system by year. Don't take the printout of that. Then arrange the paper from starting to the current year. That means sometimes your work will be started in 1977. First paper will be 1977 up to 2020. Like that, you arrange the paper. Then you rashly go through the paper. Some of the papers are not relevant to your area. Sometimes the author referred for some other purpose. So that is not belong to your area. So eliminate all the papers that is not belong to your area. Right? Then again you arrange by years. Then take a printout. After finalizing everything only, you have to take a printout. Then review the literature. How to review means, you have to review start from the starting point paper. Don't review from the current year. Then it is very difficult. First you have to start from the starting point. For example, your work will be started in 1977. First you read that paper. So here, reading the entire paper, it is very easy. It's easy. One or two paper, it is difficult. Then by seeing the synopsis or the abstract as well as the conclusion and the heading, you may find out what are the work carried out in that paper. You can easily find out. So one or two paper, to read one or two paper will be you find difficulty. Otherwise, remaining paper, it is easy to review. So while reading the paper, you keep a note with you. In that note, first you write the name of the author of the paper. Next, in the bracket, you put the year of publication. Then what are the findings you find out? Which method they used? Which parameters they are taken? What the output they received? So what comparison they made? Everything you note down it. It is very, very important. So this is called a literature review. Because after completing your work, when you are preparing thesis, one chapter is literature review. At that time, this will be more useful. You can complete your literature review within one day because already you recorded everything. So like this, all the paper you review. If you review all the paper, definitely you can come to a conclusion. What are the works previously carried out in your area? What are the technology or method or algorithm they used? And what are the method left? The left, this is called problem statement. So next one is problem statement, identifying the problem. So how you can identify your problem means based on the literature review only. That is very, very important. Right? So solving your base paper using two new technology, new algorithm, new control technique and improve the parameter in your base paper. That is one way of identifying your problem. Right now your problem is identified because you know that already you made the literature review. What are the technology they used? What are the algorithm they used? What are the parameters they are taken? Now, what are the new technology now in the market? Right? What are the emerging technology? By incorporating emerging technology in your base paper, if you can able to improve some of the parameters already given in the base paper, definitely your work will be over. This is one method of identifying your research problem. But if you are identified your research problem and the method in which or the technology in which you are going to solve, your 80% of the work will be over. So most of the researcher, they are not doing these two. They will not do literature review. They will not properly identify the problem. That's why they are finding difficult to complete their research. So this is the one method. So solving your base paper using new technology, new algorithm, new control technique and improve some of the parameter in your base paper. Already I told that if the parameter attained so far is 80%, then you can improve to 85%. Then it's a very good research. Here, what is the major problem faced by the researcher means, they are using new technology, new method, new algorithm, but the parameters, it is not possible to improve the parameters. Old conventional method is giving better result. For example, you can go to advanced controllers, but PA is giving better result than advanced controllers. Then what we can do? So this is the problem some of the researchers are facing here. So they are implementing new technology, but the improvement, the parameters, it is not possible to achieve. Most of the researchers, they are working towards this for 2 years. After that, they come to a conclusion, it is not possible to improve the result. Then they are changing their problem statement. So that is also another difficulty if you select the problem statement like this. It is another way of selecting your problem statement. So this is the best method of selecting problem statement. Actually, I can share my experience in this. I started my research in 17 years back. At that time, I decided to do my research in power electronics because I belong to EEE. Decided to do my research in power electronics. I selected converters for my research, power converters. I selected buck boost and buck boost converters. Then I did the literature review. At that time, nobody tried with neurofuzzy controller.
So at that time I am saying, not now, neuropathy controller. So I decided to do neuropathy controller. So actually most of the researcher, they did their research. So what is the research in power converter, this buck boost converter. So to maintain the constant set value, they used this controllers. It will maintain a constant set value. So most of the works are like this. So then I thought that if I implement a neurofuzzy controller, suppose it is not giving better result than conventional reset, then our work will be waste. So that I decided to contact the engineer, those who are manufacturing this buck boost and buck boost converter. I found the engineer. So those who are in production, they are doing this buck boost and buck boost converter. I get the appointment of that engineer and discuss with that engineer, is there is any problem you are facing in these three converters? Right, while manufacturing, is there is any problem you are facing it? They told that when the input voltage change as well as the load change, so suddenly the voltage set value go to the peak, for some duration only they are come to a set value. Initially it is in the set value. Suddenly when the load change or input voltage change, the voltage go to some peak value, then come to the set value. These two problems, one is peak overshoot, another one is the settling time. These two problems we are facing it. If you are able to reduce these two, definitely the converter can be used very effectively for biomedical purpose also, because biomedical purpose, definitely the accuracy is very, very important. So the converter can be converted into a efficient converter, sir. If you are able to do this, it is well and good. So I got the problem statement. So our aim is to reduce the peak overshoot and settling time, because most of the researcher, they used to convert the controllers to maintain the constant voltage. That the works are there. If I am doing the same work, means I will also find difficulty. So I reduce this overshoot and settling time. Easily I completed my research. So this is the best method of identifying your problem in your area. In your area, so you discuss with the industrial expert, identify the difficulty faced by them. So they will say, so some difficulty in this area, in this part I am finding difficulty. If you are able to solve that difficulty by using new technology, new method or new algorithm, definitely you can complete your research in a short span, as well as easily you can publish paper in a well-reputed journals. I can share some of the experience of my research scholar, those who are doing research under me. Some of the research scholar, they will come and they say that, sir, I am going to do research in image processing, that too, biomedical imaging. Immediately I will ask the student, go and meet the radiologist, those who are scanning the images and they are looking a lot of images and giving inference. That's what radiologist, work of radiologist is, they must go through various images and they will write the commands for the images. They look into a lot of images. If they discuss with that people, they can say if there is any shadow in any of the image or any boundary is not able to detect, some problem is there, means definitely they will say, if you address that problem, immediately your work will be over. So this is the effective method of finding the problem statement. If you find your problem statement, easily you can complete your research in a short span. Next, how to proceed research? This is another important thing. First thing is, right, you identify the tool. For example, most of the people, they are doing research by using MATLAB. So now, must you master the tool? That is very, very important. Most of the researchers, they will not study the tool that they are going to do in the research. Similarly, the problem statement, when you are identifying the problem statement, you can able to identify what are the technology you are going to use in your research. Next, you master that technology also. That is very, very important. Right? If you do these two, definitely you can complete your research even 6 months. First, you must master the tool. There are a lot of workshops are going on. Lot of faculty development program, lot of seminars are going on in these areas, recent areas. You attend that and you study or master the tool and the technology that you are going to use in the research. Then, don't do any advanced method. Don't try that initially. First, solve your base paper. That is the first step. Nobody will do this. Right? You have a base paper. the recent journal of your area, the recent paper published in the journal of your area. You take that paper and solve that paper first. That is the first step in the research. You solve that, whether you are getting the answer, right? Same method you implement it, right? So whether you are getting the correct result, first you study that. That is very, very important. Next, after solving your base paper, then you solve one or two new technique implement in your paper and solve it. Then immediately by using these three methods, you prepare a paper and send to a very reputed journal. You may ask a question, sir, immediately paper will accept it. No, paper will not be accepted. But you can get comments from the reviewer. That is very, very important. If you get the comments, your work will be over. Right? If you got the comments, means you can implement the comments in your work or incorporate all the suggestions given by the reviewer in your work will be over. So this is the way you have to proceed your research. After identifying your problem and identifying your technology or the method and algorithm, so this is the method you have to proceed the research. First you have to master the tool and technology, solve the base paper first. Then only if you solve the base paper, means you can get clear idea in your area, then you try with one or two methods, then prepare a paper, send to a reputed journal, right? If they given the comments, means well and good, incorporate the comments, then your work will be over. Now I am going to give some of the new technique available. You can utilize this method for your research. Advanced technology in image processing, in image enhancement, boosted non-local mean filter, persona malik diffusion with unsharp masking filter. These two techniques are emerging techniques. You can try with this. Similarly, image segmentation, nanotechnology based segmentation, improved histogram based fast 2D, Otsu's thresholding, super pixel based clustering approach. These three are some of the recent technology in image segmentation. In image classification, boosted deep convolutional neural network, recurrent convolutional neural network, SVM based sequence minimum optimization. So these are the three advanced technology in image classification. Those who are doing image processing can try with these three methods. Similarly, those who are in power system or power electronics, you can use these recent optimization techniques or algorithms, Harris-Ox optimization, black window optimization, red deer algorithm, cultural psychote optimization algorithm, Bison behavior algorithm, naked mold red optimization, regular butterfly optimization, artificial electric field algorithm, blurred edge search algorithm. So this optimization you can use and you can solve your problem. Then you will have easily you can complete your research. Similarly, the recent controllers are adaptive super twisting, sliding mode control, ice to optimal control, model predictive control. So these three controllers, by using these three controllers, if you are implementing these three controllers for your problem or problem for your base paper, definitely you can solve that base paper. You can get improved your parameters and you can complete your research. Another best way of doing the research is, there are lot of emerging technologies, cloud technology, big data, IoT, Loon technology, Hyperloop technology. This Loon and Hyperloop technologies is a very emerging technology. That's not implemented so far. Deep learning as well as blockchain technology. So these technologies, lot of engineers are developing these technology. Lot of developments are going on in these new technology. If you can able to approach the engineer and ask, what are the problem you are facing in this technology? For example, you are decided to do in big data or IoT. So for example, you take IoT. Lot of engineers are developing this IoT. The IoT technology they are developing. If you send a mail, sir, I am doing research in IoT. So if you are finding any difficulty in IoT, you can give so that I can implement that. So I am doing research in that area. Definitely they will suggest some of the problem they are facing in developing IoT. So if you solve that problem, immediately your work will be over. It is very easy to complete your research if you take a problem of recent and developed technology so that you can complete your research. So far, I discuss so the various methods you can do the research. If you do the systematic procedure, what I explained so far, definitely you can complete your research in a short span, as well as you can publish paper in a well-reputed journals, as well as you can file patents also. You will get lot of recognition. So implement the methods what I explained. Do your research. Do quality research. So quality research means, so research must be converted into patent. That's called quality research. And publish paper in reputed journals. Get lot of recognition. Thank you for watching this webinar. Thank you for patient hearing. Thank you. Now it's a question section. You can switch on your mic. You can ask questions.